is open this evening as we welcome you to Chase Field in Phoenix. It's Game 3 of the AL Championship Series between the New York Yankees and the Houston Astros. It's Game 3 of the ALCS next. So here is DJ LeMahieu, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Fly ball right down the line and left. After it is Brantley, but he won't get there. It falls in. Standing in now, Aaron Judge, fouled off. LeMahieu on at first, nobody out. That's back toward the mound. This will be a tough turn, however. To second for one to Gurriel, and they get them both. Digging in now for the Yankees, Aaron Hicks, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box. Fouled away. Two balls and two strikes to Hicks now.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate.
And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. Out of here to the deepest part of the yard. So now to the plate, Giancarlo Stanton. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
Take a step back right here. After three fastballs in a row, there is no chance he throws you a fourth.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. Bouncer to the left side. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Second baseman Jose Altuve to get things kicked off in the home half of inning number one. The 2-2.
Okay. Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Fastball call, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Now one down with the bases empty, and that'll bring up Alex Bregman.
Bregman
on the ground to the left side, and in the left field for a one-out hit.
That is good. No left field. Michael Brantley.
To the plate now, Michael Brantley, and they pitch out here, but nothing's happened. Ball two. Runner at first here, one man out. There goes Bregman off of first. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Frazier will get there with ease as he puts it away for out number two. Runner at first with two gone in the inning. And ambling over to the batter's box is Carlos Correa. Correa in front, three balls and a strike.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
Swing and a flare down the line. Urshela in the shallow left. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. Into the box, Yordan Alvarez. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Second inning set to go, and Here comes the first baseman, Luke Voit. 1-1. Hit softly on the ground to third. Bregman has it. Throw is in time for the first out of the second. One out, base is empty, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Breaking ball there is down. Good job of laying off. It's back to 2-2.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Throw on to first is in time, and Grinke's got himself two outs. Stepping in next, Clint Frazier. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
One strike.
Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. The 2-2. Hit the other way out toward right field. Tucker waits on it, and that's the third out. Last half of the second set to go, and next will be the speed threat, Yuli Gurriel. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Two balls and two strikes now.
2-2.
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. Kyle Tucker is on deck. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. Striding in for Houston, Kyle Tucker. Yankees lead this 1-0 here in inning number two. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
Oh, this is what you get fired up for right here. Hard fastball against a power hitter. I know he was late right there, but if he comes back, this one might not come back.
And he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out. And now here is Miles Straw trying to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1.
2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
3-1.
And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now. And he looks at ball four now. So he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of a steal when he's on base.
The catcher, Jason Castro.
And he takes a cold strike, too. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher.
Well, he's been laboring a bit through these first two innings of work. That's 37 pitches. And ideally, he'd be closer to 27 instead.
Full count, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Gets him looking, strike three. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Gio Urshela. Misses, ball two.
We all know he's a really good hitter. This is probably a good example why. He fell behind 0-2, but knowing they're probably going to try to get him to chase a pitcher's pitch, he got really patient. He's still up against the ropes a little, but he's in a much better position now on a 2-2 count.
Bounces to the left side. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. Next to hit, Gary Sanchez.
The captain, Gary.
fouled away. Here now the 2-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Center fielder giving chase. He gets there, and that's the second out. So back to the top of the Yankee order. Digging in, DJ LeMahieu singled in his last at-bat. Greinke ready now, the 1-1. Up high, 2-1 now. Two out, nobody on. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Strum will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Jose Altuve. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. Alex Bregman will be next. Popped him up. Boyd is under it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. One out now in the Houston third, and that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. The 2-2. Right side. In time to first, and there are two away. So the bases are empty with two gone now, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Lifted down the line and left. And it's a foul ball. Bases are empty here with two men out. Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the side. For the start of the fourth, and that'll bring up the former American League Rookie of the Year, Big Aaron Judge. The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Count even at 2-2. Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Fly ball out toward left center field. Strum is right there, and he's got it for out number one. Ready now is Aaron Hicks. Off to a fine start in this one after launching a homer his first time up.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
And a big swing and a miss here, two strikes.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
And that'll get down for a base hit. And he'll reach second now with one away. Now, Giancarlo Stanton. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. Stepping in once again is Luke Voigt, runner in scoring position with two gone. He tried to get that one airborne, but it's 1-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation.
That will have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. For the last half of the inning, and stepping in as the veteran shortstop, Carlos Correa. Hey. One and two now. It just catches the outer half.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through four, five, and six right here.
Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at two balls and two strikes. And a full count as that misses. It's three and two now.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
And that misses for ball four. The leadoff walk that's starting at the bottom of the fourth.
Designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez.
One and two now. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at two and two. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that's through for a base hit. Make him one for two in this one. And now they'll have runners at the corners to start off the inning.
The first pitch out of 10. Yuli Gurriel.
At the plate now, Yuli Gurriel. Takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Set the deal on two and two. Fastball is outside and it's full now, three and two. Kyle Tucker is on deck. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Hicks is under it. He's there to make the catch, and here comes the runner from third as this should get him on the board. And the run will score from third as that ties things at one. Next up for the Stros, Kyle Tucker, 0-for-1 after a pop-out in foul territory his first time through.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
The 2-2. Into right field, that's a base hit. They'll hold at second, and there are two aboard now. Standing in now, Miles Straw. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. LeMahieu for one. On to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw.
Now got it.
Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. 0-for-1, went down looking his first time up.
Yeah, and they throws him on a good changeup. Tough one. If you got good arm action, and this pitcher certainly does have good arm action out there, tough to decipher between the fastball and changeup. He's got to be willing to stay back and take the ball the other way.
And this one's high and tight, backing him up, 2-1.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
One run, four hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Into the box, Gleyber Torres comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Two, as this is fouled back right off the catcher's mask that time, as he may need a second to clear the cobwebs here. Just hung in there on that one. Here he comes again, 1-2.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get the chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him, so we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
Count full, three balls and two strikes. Curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. Still three balls and two strikes, the eighth pitch of the at-bat. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning. So next to hit is Clint Frazier. He flew out in his last AB. Set and the 1-1 pitch. Good slider there. Gets a swing and miss. And he fouls this one off. Now another 1-2. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Now a swinging bunt. On the ground is short. This could be two. Right to him. Altuve for one. To Gurriel, and they get them both. Bring in Giovanni Urshela. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Hit on the ground out to short. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first. Saves an error as the side is retired. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Jose Altuve. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve. Strike two, swinging just out in front of the slider. Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Boy, this is the tight one. You kind of get the feeling like the next team that scores is going to win this one.
Hit well on the ground to first. Throw just in time as he was flying down the line that time. And that'll bring up Alex Bregman. One for two. He's singled and grounded out so far. The 1-1 home.
At the ball.
I know he fouled that pitch off right there, but he was definitely out in front. He was cheating to a heater, no question about it.
You can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
Number 23.
So the bases are empty here with two gone. And that brings in the left-handed hitting outfielder, Michael Brantley. Pulled toward right center field. Hicks is under it, and the inning is over. Half of the sixth about to get started, and the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher Gary Sanchez. Now the 1-1 pitch. Strike two, swinging.
One ball.
Fouled off. The next 1-2 pitch. Away.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. And it's fouled away. One out, nobody on. Down the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring up the big bat of Aaron Judge. And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and that'll bring in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. Back up the middle, and that'll get through into center field for a base hit. Tag will be too late as they take the lead now at 2-1. Carlos Stanton. A swing and he pops him up on the infield. And the infield fly rule will be in effect here. So next to bat will be
Luke Voit.
We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away.
There isn't a hitter alive that doesn't love hitting in fastball counts like 3-1. It's usually a pretty fruitful count in terms of getting a pitch to drive.
Well, he's having a good amount of success here, Dan, even though he hasn't really gotten a ton of swings and misses.
Yeah, it amazes me how every game you pitch can be so different, Matt. Sometimes it feels like guys can't touch you and you're just punching everyone out. But other times, you don't have your good stuff and you really rely on movement and location to get outs. That's been the case for him today, and it's really working.
Josh James answers the call to pitch here in a big spot. He inherits a bases loaded jam, but needs just one out to get out of it.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first, and no swing. It's ball two. The 2-2 pitch. Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been as they'll strand the bases loaded. This side is retired. Davey Garcia enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 83.
Bottom of the sixth inning now. And stepping up as the shortstop, Carlos Correa. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2.
You like the modern style of baseball. Here it is. Both starters kept their teams in the game. It's close right now. Now we hand it over to the nasty bullpens. Let's see what matchups are going to take place.
So he gets the swinging strikeout on the changeup. Carlos Correa sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning. Count still full, 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
He loses him on ball four. Here's a little chopper up the middle. Torres at the bag. But wisely, no thought of a return throw, and the inning will continue. Justin Wilson comes on now, and this move looks to be all about playing the matchup here.
Yeah, and I don't think there's any doubt about that, Matt. They want the lefty-lefty matchup, and that's usually the right move, but we'll just have to see how this plays out.
Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. 2-2 the count. Hits are now even at four apiece. Lifted the other way to left center. Hicks on the move. He's not going to have a play on it, and this might bring home the runner from first. Now the relay home, and he will be tagged out at the plate. So it remains a one-run deficit here as the side is retired. And now Clint Frazier. Fastball called strike. 1-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Next, it'll be Gio Urshela. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. 1-1. He's in there for strike number two. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
I think he's shown you right there he's trying to put you away with the off-speed pitch. Have to be leery of that right there and take pull side away. That'll keep you on all stuff, fastballs and the off-speed.
Catch made there by Altuve, and there are two gone now. Now to the plate, Gary Sanchez. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. And he fouls this one off. Another 2-2 offering. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired.
strike.
Garen O'Dea gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 56.
Bottom of the inning now, and next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Miles Straw.
Down by one, I'm interested to see how they approach this as an offense, especially if they get someone on base early in the inning. Some teams, you know, they're going to try and manufacture that run, just trying to get that one run across. Others, they're going to look for one or two big swings to make it happen.
Next, here is Jason Castro, 0-for-2 for him to this point.
Castro.
The 1-1 pitch. Swings through it for strike number two. Still a ball and two strikes. We're in the seventh inning now. The pitcher's duel, 2-1 our score. And that's the second out. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. He's 0-for-3 so far, so he hasn't done much to help at the top of the lineup. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu. 1-1 is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike two.
You never want to take the aggression away from a ball player, but in this situation, I'd like to see the leadoff guy try and work the count a little bit more, especially when his pitcher's missing like he is.
And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So now into the box is Aaron Judge. He's 0-for-2 with a walk thus far. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Into the windup and the pitch. Very weakly on the ground. Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. And now a slider in there for a called third strike. And there are two gone now. Now with that bat, you don't want to miss. And here is Aaron Hicks. And he needs just a triple for the cycle. So let's see if he can put one in the gap. Here's a fly ball, well hit. Brantley going back at the track. And he'll pull into second with his fourth hit of the ball game. Into the box, Giancarlo Stanton. No offer on that one, two balls and a strike. Strike two swinging just out in front of the slider.
That's a really nice thing about pitching with the base open. You can work out of the strike zone a little bit more and try to get a guy to chase your pitch just like that one.
And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with two out. Next to hit is Luke Voit. And a big at bat in this one. Two on, two away here in the eighth. Two balls and a strike to the Yankees first baseman.
Well, the Yankees have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to see if they can get it, but now it sure would be a good time.
Fouled off. Now Boyd with a high fly ball out to deep left field. And that one is gone. On a two-strike count with two away in the inning. Joe Smith enters the ballgame out of the pen looking for the final out here in the top of inning number eight.
Number
So now to the plate, Gleyber Torres. Lying toward the gap in left center. Strong, able to track it down for the third out. Jonathan Loaisiga is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Bottom of inning number eight set to go, and set to go is the third baseman, Alex Bregman. The 2-1. Seared down the first baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Now the pitch.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
Now the 3-2 pitch. High in the air into shallow left center. Frazier comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number one. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Off-speed pitch, and this one runs in and nearly gets him here. All even now, 2-2. Fouled away. 5-1 our score as we play the eighth. So a full count now. Carlos Correa waits on deck. Right into the shift, and he'll step on first himself for the out. Up next, Carlos Correa. Lifetime versus this pitcher. Not a big sample size, 0-1. The 1-1 home. Fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Set to start the ninth in this one, and next it'll be the outfielder, Clint Frazier. Here comes the 1-2. Sent on the ground out to second. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Stepping up is Gio Urshela, flew out last time up. Bases are empty, one man. Well off the inside that time as the sinker misses for a ball. Just off the inside part of the plate, it's 3-1. Gary Sanchez will be next. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four. Striding in is Gary Sanchez. 0-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Takes that one a little bit low. Three balls and a strike now.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
And the count will be full. Urshela stands at first with one out. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. DJ LeMahieu grounded out in his last at bat. 1-2 to DJ LeMahieu.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider right there. Always felt toughest pitch in the game. If you're a guy who liked to work the big part of the field.
Swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Zach Britton, 6'1" and southpaw, will be the one that gets the call from the bullpen here.
number 53.
At the plate now is the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. It was a walk in his last trip. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Bouncer up the middle, and this is going to scoot on through into center for a base hit leading off the inning.
The first pitch, number 10, Julius Peer.
Stepping in now, Yuli Gurriel. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. A runner at first with no outs here. Hit back up the middle. Mayhew's got it. Torres at the bag. Back to first. The ninth inning double play, and they're an out away from closing this one out. Next up, Kyle Tucker comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Last strike now for Houston. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Drilled to the right side, and that is through into right field for a single. Chad Green will make an appearance here as he is in charge of trying to ring up the final out of the ball game. Standing in now, Miles Straw. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Gloved by LeMahieu. Throw on to first, and the Yankees are going to help this series hold form. All three games won by the visitors so far as this one is over.
You might think it's just another win, but it's awfully hard to win in this game, especially on the road. But they find a way to get it done, and they should be very happy with this performance.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. Tonight's game comes to an end. 5-1 the final score. The New York Yankees trail 2-1 in this postseason series. Luis Severino earns the victory on the mound. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, 5 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Astros, 1 run, 7 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 47 minutes.